Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.1 Developer Beta 2. This is available to all developers, all iOS 13 supported devices, and if you're waiting for that public beta, it will be out later today or sometime tomorrow, or maybe by the time you're watching this. Now, if you're wondering about iOS 13, where that's at, well, do not expect another update until the actual Apple keynote, which is on September 10th. It's a Tuesday. Apple will show off the next iPhones, the iPhone 11 and those different models, and maybe some other things as well. And then also you'll be able to get the GM or Golden Master after that. That's how they've done it every year for many years. So I would expect iOS 13 GM then, and then we'll figure out how we can install iOS 13 if we don't want to be on iOS 13.1. Now, this one came in at 280.4 megabytes on my iPhone XS Max, similarly sized on all the other devices here. So let's take a look at the build number. You can see the build number is 17A5831C. And this particular build number really means we've got a ways to go as far as the final version. Normally when there's a C, we're waiting for B and A, and I would expect this version to actually, or iOS 13.1 to maybe release in October or maybe even later. Now in this particular beta, there are 26 known issues that still remain, but there are a lot of fixed ones. However, the notes do not mention any resolved issues whatsoever. Now, the one thing that is fixed, at least for me so far today, is LTE. There's a new modem firmware in iOS 13.1 beta 2. And so far when I leave a Wi-Fi network, it jumps over to LTE, no problem. Earlier in the day when I was on beta 1, this was really bad. So right now it's working really well. Now, as far as things that are fixed in this particular update, there's quite a few little things that are fixed that were broken in the previous version. So if we go into photos and then I go to share this wallpaper, this is today's wallpaper. And of course I'll link it in the description as I always do. We'll go ahead and share here. And you'll see the share sheet is actually fixed. So all of the icons are still there. Of course I have them blurred out, but you'll see that you can actually see my AirDrop icon, and this is working properly now. Now, if we slide up and we use this as a wallpaper, we can now move this around again. We can resize the wallpaper that was broken before. They've since fixed that. So that part's great. I'm glad it's working again. And then also if you had a problem with Hangouts crashing, that's working again as well. So those things are fixed that you can see, and thankfully it's all working properly. Now on the iPad, we had some issues with folders and moving them around, and they've fixed this as well. And this is a new little pop-up. You'll see it says Today View, add the Today View. We already knew about the Today View, but this is just showing up. So we'll just add it to the home screen here and it goes away. Now, as far as the folders go, these work a lot better now. You'll see, we'll wait for it there. We can create a folder. They don't blank out or go away. And they do seem to be a little bit darker as well, especially if you have your device on dark mode. If you have dark mode turned on, it's actually the wallpaper seems to be a little bit darker. So if we go to light, you'll see there's the wallpaper. Then we'll go back over here. I don't have the shortcut on here, of course. And now we're back to dark mode. So the wallpaper does seem to respond and gets a little bit darker. Now, aside from the home screen being fixed, there are a couple new things here and there as well. There's a new feature in settings. If we go to settings and then we go down to shortcuts, and here you'll see there's allow untrusted shortcuts. If you turn this off and back on, it's going to say allow untrusted shortcuts. Apple does not review shortcuts outside of the gallery. Running shortcuts from untrusted sources can put your personal device or personal data at risk. If we allow this, we need to put in our passcode. So we'll allow it, put in the passcode. Now, once we've turned that on, if we go home and then we go to shortcuts, wherever I've put that, I just put it in a folder. We'll go into shortcuts, and then maybe I want to share this shortcut. So log caffeine, tap the three dots. Now I can actually share it in the bottom right. So we'll go ahead and share it. And you'll see here, it gives me some actions. If I hit copy iCloud link, it says create iCloud link. Anyone with access to this shared link will be able to view the contents of this shortcut. So it's warning you if you want to share this. So you can copy it and then you're good to go. In order to do this, you must be signed into iCloud. This iPad is not. Now that particular link was not on my iPhone. So if I go into my iPhone here, the shortcuts option is not there. So we'll go back. If I go down to shortcuts, the actual share option isn't there. So you may or may not have this. I'm not sure why it's on my iPad. It's not on my phones. For some people it is, some for some others it is not. So I'm not sure why that is, but you may or may not have that. Now, again, on the iPad, there's one more small change. We'll go back here. We'll go to settings. And if we go to settings and then we go to display and brightness, under display and brightness, if we go to the bottom, the home screen layout has changed. It's now animated. You'll see it says more and bigger. And then it also says keep today view on the home screen. This used to be under the widget itself. Now we can just turn it on and off with a toggle, and it says home screen layout. So they've just changed this around a little bit, minor changes, but they have tweaked it. So let's go back home and take a look at a couple other new things. Now, another thing I noticed that seemed new to me was under podcasts. And if you go to podcasts and hit search, it now says new in Apple Podcasts, search the audio. Now, we knew we could do this before. You can search the actual audio of a podcast. So maybe we'll type in iPhone 11 and see what comes up. We'll search all podcasts and see if it finds anything, and you should be able to search it now. So any of these podcasts actually mention iPhone 11. So that should be something that's different as well. It's just a new little blurb there, but we knew we would be able to search those before. Now, also some are saying that the actual spacing on the dock is a little bit different. I don't see this. You may or may not notice it, but if it is, it's very slight. I compared it to different iPhones running different versions of iOS. In fact, let me bring over my iPhone XR. The spacing may or may not be different. This is actually on a previous version, so the spacing may or may not be different. I don't really see it. Also, there is one thing that we won't be able to see yet, but when you're charging your device and you're going to do an update, there will be a new message that has to do with either wireless charging versus wired charging and being able to update, not worrying about the charge level. So we'll see that when the next update comes out, but that's something they've added that's actually in the code itself. Now, as far as issues that still remain, mail is still super buggy. It seems to be for most people already, or still. I'm surprised they haven't actually fixed this, but hopefully they'll fix this soon, because that's a major problem for myself. I really don't enjoy using the mail app because it's kind of a pain. It doesn't work properly. Now, as far as performance, it feels very fast and super smooth. So if we go in here, you'll see it's nice and smooth. And then 3D touching actually feels very similar to haptic touch, but it's very fast. So it doesn't seem to feel as though it's pressure sensitive, but it's what the new 3D touch is. Now, on older devices, people in forums are actually saying they're seeing good performance on older devices as well, such as the SE, and we'll look at the 6S Plus in a moment. But again, scrolling is fast, going into music. Maybe we'll go out of that. We'll go into the App Store. Give it a second to load. It's the first time I've opened it. And you'll see it's pretty smooth and fast. No problems there whatsoever. And again, on the 6S Plus, we should see the same thing. So with the 6S, I haven't opened the App Store yet. There we go. Nice and smooth. Let's open music. Again. Well, it was a little choppy there, and it usually is as it's loading for a second. But it's not too bad. It seems like it's nice and fast, even on these older devices. So that's really nice. It should play your games fine. Of course, it's a little bit of a mystery how we're going to get back to iOS 13 if we want to be on that. Now, as far as battery is going to take a few days to measure. I always do a follow-up where I ask how it's been for you, but the previous beta was okay. I would say it's on par with what we had before. And here's over the last 10 days, I'm usually getting about 6 to 6.5 hours with an entire battery charge. So usually by the time I go to bed, I've done about 4.5 hours of screen on time and maybe an hour of screen off time, just depending on the day and how much I use the device. And then I'll have 20 or 30% left. I wouldn't say it's phenomenal, but it's okay. We'll check it in a few days, but it is a beta and it's not as relevant on beta software. And then there's one final thing that isn't related to iOS so much as it is to Apple TV, which was updated, and they'll have a keep watching screen. And so we'll see that on some of the other ones as far as keep watching and seeing how that does. And it may prompt you after watching a couple different videos to say, do you want to keep watching? Now, as far as the Geekbench is concerned, I know a lot of you asked about that. So I've run it on all of these devices. So I'll open that up in just a moment and let's take a look at Geekbench on all of them. So we'll open Geekbench, and on my iPhone XS Max, I have a score of 4,801, 11,448. Now, there is a new version of Geekbench out. I didn't use that just for consistency's sake, but I will switch over to that once the new iPhones come out. So we'll go to history here, we'll go to CPU, and if we take a look compared to the previous version, we're right about the same. We're within 20 to 50 points. So basically it's going to be the same for most people, but let me lay all of these out so you can get an idea of what this should be as far as Geekbench, and we'll take a look at it. Now from left to right, we have the iPad Air 2, then the iPhone SE, then the iPhone 6S Plus, and then the iPhone XS Max. So these are all the different devices and what their Geekbench scores are. That's it for iOS 13.1 Beta 2. What do you think about it? Let me know in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.